Hi, this is Steve Trevelise. Huge Giant fan, huge Eli Manning fan. I got the Eli jersey, got the Eli action figurine, which I stole from my son Albert's room. Shh. I even got an Eli Manning autographed jersey. See that? At least I hope it's an Eli Manning autographed jersey. See, Eli's been coming under fire lately. He's being sued for selling memorabilia that may not be exactly what they're representing it to be. And regardless of how the case comes out, he could still end up being suspended. Even if your conduct does not result in a criminal conviction, says the NFL, if the league finds that you have engaged in any of the following conduct, you will be subject to discipline. And then it goes on. Conduct by anyone in the league that is illegal, violent, dangerous, or irresponsible puts innocent victims at risk, damages the reputation of others in the game, and undercuts public respect and support for the NFL. We must endeavor at all times to be people of high character. We must show respect for others inside and outside our workplace. We must strive to conduct ourselves in ways that favorably reflect on ourselves, our teams, the communities we represent, and the NFL. So they're going to do their own investigation to see what exactly happened in this email scandal. So what do they have on Eli Manning? Okay, in April 2010, an email that Eli sent to the equipment director asking for two helmets that can pass as game used. This does not look good. And it gets better. How about an email exchange provided by the plaintiff, Eric Inselberg, from August 2008, in which he writes to the equipment director, "Hey Joe, my buddy was offered an Eli game-used helmet and jersey. Are these the BS ones Eli asked you to make up because he didn't want to give up the real stuff?" Skiba's reply is listed as, "BS ones, you are correct." Really not looking good here. The Giant lawyers say the emails are taken out of context and attack the character of the memorabilia dealers. Governor Christie says, okay, if they're taken out of context, then you must have all the emails. Put it in context. Show us where Eli was only joking. I say this is another reason why Eli Manning could never be a Jersey guy. Because a Jersey guy would never, ever, ever send an email that would incriminate himself like this. It used to be you keep your mouth shut. Now in 2017, you keep your mouth shut and your email off. A Jersey guy wouldn't put someone else like the equipment director in the middle of this, who luckily told the truth here. And also, a Jersey guy wouldn't take his team and his fans, who are praying for another Super Bowl run, out of the running by getting suspended for four games over something this ridiculous. He's not making enough money, not getting enough from the NFL, from DirecTV, from Dunkin' Donuts, from Toyota, from everybody else that wants to give him money. He's got to sell memorabilia. And if you're going to sell memorabilia, a Jersey guy would not screw over the person who's paying thousands of dollars and give them the right memorabilia. I'm not saying Eli did any of this. I don't know. But if he did, and in the National Football League, even if he didn't, he's subject to a suspension, which could lead the Giant fans to have all their hopes and dreams resting on the quarterback of Geno Smith. I'm feeling a little sick. I gotta go.